I'm not gonna say welcome until... Hey, Glenos, and welcome to another stream! How amazing, huh? I'm trying to get all of my windows up on the same time. How's good, Mr. Glenos? How are you doing? So yeah, I'm gonna do a little bit of solo streaming today. Because I'm sad like that, you know? No, I'm just kidding. I'm just brave enough to do it alone. So I'm gonna draw a keyframe of this old woman holding her leg up in a non-realistic fashion. What a coincidence, I'm drawing too, but just a regular drawing. That's I'm glad to hear that. You were the one that did the Two-Face stream, right? Was good stuff. So yeah, I'm not gonna talk way too much during this stream. I'm just gonna get some work done, you know. Ah, great to hear. Doing good stuff, buddy. Man, I love Cubby. I really listened a lot to his music these last weeks. It's becoming part of my life. Man. So, Glenn, have you tried doing drawings in other programs than Flash? Like, Psy? Have you tried that?
Whoa!
Oh, thanks for following McAkery, MC Akery. Hey, Fabi, how are you doing today? MC Akery is an old viewer from when we used to do a lot of Swedish streams. But yeah, Glenn, you should try Psy. It's a good program for just drawing stuff. Yeah, I did another live stream lately where I shaded a character with Manga Studio, and the programming I'm using to draw now is also Manga Studio. Okay, that's great to hear. I've heard a lot of good stuff about Manga Studio, but I haven't tried it myself. But it's supposed to be good. I hear. Hey, hey, Lost Sasquatch, how are you doing? Morning, weehoo! I'm glad to. Have I seen you before? Welcome to the stream if you're new. Or welcome back if you're old. That's what I used to say. When I was in the army. Are you still working on that animation with the old man? Yeah, boy. But I've finished all of the shots with the old man. So now I'm working on the old woman. Whoa, check this out, my friends. It's an old woman. So yeah, If you ever wonder how far we are at, in the animation, you can look at this little slider thing here, and you can see that it's kind of like the percent of the animation done. It's kind of nifty like that, because it's just a timeline and we have everything in the program, so... That's how many parts of the animation are done. I'd eat and drink her cookies and milk if you know what I mean. Haha, me too, buddy! I drink them all night. Disgusting, I think. Ra 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 ra. Whoa, that woman is so old. Yeah, it's amazing what you can do with a digital pencil, huh? That's a good tip about the slider. Yeah, so you can just go back in the old animation streams, and then you can see, at this point they were this many percent done. It's also a bit of a way for us to keep sane, because when we see that slider move, we know we are doing some kind of progress. Or that's what we tell ourselves. Man, I went to bed at 4 AM last night. I was watching 3 live streams at the same time while chatting with someone and drawing. Yeah. Couldn't do that in the 70s, man. The technology of the ages. Yeah, I think we have the keyframes or the poses or whatever. So it's time to do in-betweens, the most fun part of it all. So yeah, I've actually had a vacation week this week. So I've gotten a lot of animation done. But I've also had a lot of entertainment to watch. So that's why I haven't been streaming. Even though it might have been a good idea to stream during this week. But yeah. The main reason you stayed up late was because you want to finish your drawings. I feel like that as well, especially these days, but now that I've been having a vacation, I've been like getting one shot done each day, and I've had that like a benchmark, so I get some stuff done. But I always try to get up early instead of staying up late. It keeps me sane. And that way I don't have to go through hell when I get back to work and have to get up early again and have to turn my day all around again. My day job, that's I'm a 3D animator for a game studio. So I get to do 3D realistic animations as my day job and wacky 2D animations on my free time. So I'm a lucky fuck. Mm-hmm. that's why everybody did drugs in the 70s. Yeah, because they couldn't stay up late and watch live streams. I'm glad all the drugs disappeared after that. Huh? Thank God for live streams, huh? Hello, Axel. How are you doing today, you imposter? Man, I can't get this leg to look right. Ba ba da ba ba do ba do ba da. Yeah, this week I've been watching Better Call Saul. Have you guys seen that? I thought it was just gonna be like some kind of like offshoot 20-24 minute shitty milking show kinda, but it's really great and it's. They have the same guys that did Breaking Bad on it, or the directors and stuff. So it's really keeping that high standard, and it's great. And I'm glad I got that as a surprise, because it's everybody likes surprises. Doodly doodly dooda. Oh, you stopped when you in the middle of Breaking Bad. Now that's some discipline. I would never be able to do that. Fuck this foot, man. You listen to Sleepycast? Yeah. I listen to most podcasts because I commute a lot. So, podcasts keep me sane. But yeah, sometimes it's a bit too much shock comedy for me. But yeah, it's good fun. I really like podcasts like You Talking U2 to Me. That's a really good one I've been listening to lately with Scott Aukerman and Adam Scott. Where I just talk shit and try to keep it relevant to the band U2. I just can't watch TV shows through the internet. Ah, okay. Yeah, Jake and Amir's podcast is really great as well. I've been listening to that since day one, baby. I really like when Ben Schwartz is on the podcast. He's so hilarious. I mean, I love when he's on any podcast, like on Comedy Bang Bang as well, or stuff like that. Another great podcast is Dead Authors. Have you guys listened to that? It's by one of my favorite comedians, Paul F. Tompkins. And the premise of the show is that comedians improv, and they play as a dead author, and then they have nice interviews, and it's really funny. Toxic Krendor. I don't really listen to video game podcasts. I try to keep it to comedy, mostly improv comedy podcast, because that's my jam, bro. You use an MP3 player instead of your phone. Okay, this is good enough. This is a good enough foot. Let's work on this guy instead. Yeah, Thomas Middleditch. He's also one of my favorite comedians. He's super funny. I read that Lauren Lapkus podcast with special guest, which is also one of my favorite comedians. She's so funny. Her latest episode has Thomas in it, and I'm really looking forward to listen to that, because something tells me that Thomas and Lauren can really make a great podcast together. Yeah, I used to listen to Corruptional podcasts, but I don't know, it didn't really I don't know, it wasn't enough jokes, mostly just ranting, and I don't find that super interesting, but I can see how you listen to that. It's well produced. That's some wonky fucking hair. The feeling you see. Ah, you don't have a smartphone? Yeah, that's too bad, man. Usually on the mornings I pop an episode of Always Sunny in my smartphone, and a podcast episode, and then with those two, my commuting is much easier. I've been lately, like this month, I think, I've been listening to like 6 seasons of Always Sunny. I didn't think I'd like it as much as I do, but it's really great. By the way, last, I think, yeah, it was this week, I bought the game Hand of Fate. Have you guys played that? It's really fun. It's like a combination of choose your own adventure, like you know those old, that you walk into a bar, there's a shady guy, what do you do? It's a combination of that and hack and slash Arkham City or Arkham game fighting system. It's really fun. It's what is it called? It's roguelike as well, which is like one of my my favorite things, because I really like just playing a quick game and then dying, and then just keep working on animations. It's a good roguelikes are great games for animators. You can just pick it up, play around, and then get back to work. But yeah, Hand of Fate, check it out. Also, talking about TV shows, says Glenn's fan, they introduced the Joker in Gotham. Hey man, I haven't seen that episode yet, you ding-dong! But, I guess that's fine, that's fine. I'm not gonna read your comment anymore. I'm just gonna leave it at that. Is Arkham Knight the new video game? I didn't play the Origins game. If I could keep why is Walter so quiet tonight? Oh, he's moving room today, apparently. So he bailed on me. just like always when I try to stream, he's like, oh man, I gotta do this thing, and then he leaves me high and dry. But that's fine, I guess. I mean, it's not like I'm sweating for him. So, I mean, fuck that guy. No, but he's moving today, so he couldn't join. And that's fine with me. Right in front of your hot dad. Origins was really bad in my opinion. Yeah, it looked really bad. I actually I looked at when Video Games Awesome played it, Fraser and Becky, and it didn't look like a great game. Oh well, it looked like a good game, but it didn't look as good as the previous ones. But yeah, there was a different studio working on this, I guess they slipped up. No worries, Genson, you didn't really spoil anything super important. It just made me more psyched for the episode. I'm gonna buy a pizza tonight and watch it, like the stupid slob I am. Haha, yeah. Get Jojo out. Yeah, I can't really remember. Oh yeah, it was the Freeze, Dr. Freeze, Mr. Freeze. Yeah, I guess it wasn't very super appealing. Does anyone play Hearthstone or Hearthstone? I just got to the Legend for the first time. I used to play it, but I didn't have the patience for it, and to be fair, I wasn't very good as well, so... I like watching other people play it though, because I don't have to think. But yeah, I haven't played in a while. I haven't tested it out of the Gnomes and Goblins. Might do that though, but I just got Hand of Fate and Evolve, so I'm pretty fit when it comes to gaming for a while, I think. And I still haven't finished Grim Fandango, which is a great game. You should check out the remake. Ah, Mr. Freeze was the DLC? Ah, okay. So what was the main story? I can't remember what the main story was. Dying Light? Is that the... that's the parkour first-person game, right? Looks pretty fun. I mean, I don't think I would play it if it wasn't co-op. But it might be fun co-op. The game is fun after you level up for a bit. You can just tear through zombies. Yeah, but for me it seems more fun to be like, oh shit, I can't kill all these zombies, how should I parkour to get through all of these bad murders? And that's kinda more the selling point for me, more than just being super OP and just killing zombies with one slash. But yeah, each to his own. I guess that's why I like roguelikes that much as well, because there's more of a risk when playing it, so you get more invested. Have you ever gotten in trouble for not actually playing a game in a Twitch stream? Well, not really. I've never heard anything, but I know that they keep removing our old broadcasts, and that's why we keep saving them to YouTube instead. So I guess, or maybe that could be because the music, I'm not really sure. We have gotten permission to play all of the music we play, but I guess they don't really care to look that up. Or it could be that we aren't playing video games. I'm not really sure. But they are gonna have to blame themselves, because we were streaming at Justin, or yeah, Justin. And then they just removed Justin and told us that our accounts were migrated to Twitch. So fuck you, we're gonna stream on Twitch now, because that's what you force us to do. And I like the design of Twitch better anyway, so. Black Mask sent 8 assassins of the Batman. Oh, so that was the main story. Yeah, I guess if I can't even remember it, I guess it wasn't super appealing. But yeah. I really like Batman, huh? Yeah, this man. It's a good franchise. I'm not super into the movies, but I really like the games and the TV show. But I can't really get into the games. Oh, not the games, but the movies. I don't know. It just feels... I saw the latest one, and it just feels like there isn't very much character. What is it called? Like, they aren't building characters a lot. It's mostly just like action. Action, boo boo, bad guys, kill them, fighting. Explosions. And I'm more into the TV series, because it's more like character building. But yeah, I mean, that's fair. It's you have much more time to work with as well. I got leather. I think Twitch removes, Twitch just deletes streams after a month. But yeah, but I think it deletes our streams like the day after. But I might be wrong because I don't really, I haven't really checked. Since we upload to YouTube, it doesn't really matter. But we have never gotten like an email that they don't like that we're not streaming games or whatever. But we are playing some video game covers, so that should suffice, right? Yeah, the Batman villains. Good stuff, good stuff. Oh, it was Backmaster that you were working on in the manga studio. Last Sasquatch, you're not into the comic books? I've actually never actually, I don't think I've read any of the comic books, so I'm not really sure what the what level they are on, like age level kind of, what they are trying to reach, what demography. But I would like to try one out once. Really get like the most basic story. But I guess they were made for younger people, so I guess it's fair to say they are feel a bit too kid oriented. Yeah, I don't think I've actually played a call. Well, I played some Call of Duty. It can be fun when you have some friends, but I really can't see myself enjoying like the single player experience. No, not my kind of game. But each to his own, babes. Yeah, it is a cozy stream tonight. It's a bit laid back. Speaking with you fellas, drawing some lines. Listening to some great musics. By the way, if you ever feel like, hey, I want to check out some of the musicians, you can just scroll down to the description, and there's the ticket to Music Heaven. They are all super cool. All of the musicians we play on the stream, I've talked to, and I've gotten an A-OK to play their music because they are cool people that deserve to be shared with the world. Oh, I'm a bit sniffly. Hey Glenn, why are you writing an at symbol before the name? Is that some kind of shortcut to writing a user's name? Or is that just your little way of spicing things up? I look forward to having this this project done. I really feel like doing a Blender project again. It's really great to know both 2D and 3D, so you can switch it up. Like when you're done with the 2D animation, you can be like, ah, okay, that's a good amount of 2D animation. Now I feel like doing some 3D, baby. And you can do that. It's really different experiences, and if you switch it up, you'll get so much more enjoyment out of it. Because you don't work on a project long enough to get tired of it. So if you do another, if I were to do another 2D project now, maybe I'd feel a bit tired because I've been doing 2D projects for so many months, but I can just switch it up with some 3D. I think I've got a pretty good premise for the next one as well, the next 3D project. I would like to make a series out of it as well because, you know, since you have the assets in 3D, it's very smart to do a series instead because you don't have to do new characters and new rigs and all that stuff. When you work in 2D, it's really the same kind of work if you do a series because you have to redraw each shot anyway. But if you were to do more episodes of a 3D animation, you could just reuse the old rigs, maybe add a new character or whatever. So yeah, I think I'm gonna try to go for something like that. That would be really fun. And I would also love to stream some 3D animation as well, because we haven't really done that. And maybe people would be a bit interested in learning about Blender, since it's free and stuff, so anyone could pick it up whenever they want. So maybe there's a bit more. More people wanting to see that. Who knows? I'm gonna do it anyway, fuck you. Haha! Well, if you type it, the person whose username you type will see his name and he/she will know that you're. Ah! That's interesting. I didn't know that. You're like the Twitch magician, man. I've been, if you guys remember the sword that Casper was working on. The last stream, I think it was. He finished it up and it looks super great. And I got the. I got him to send it to me so I could put it into Blender and have some fun with it. And I did a little video where I killed the coach from Left 4 Dead. I'm gonna show you guys. I'm pretty sure he's okay with it. So let's see this. Pick it up.
Ain't none of my business what y'all doing out there.
Yeah, pretty disgusting, huh? But yeah, it's a bit. It might be a bit darker on your screens. I'm not really sure, but yesterday I sat and tried to figure out how to do these embers that fly off the sword. Because I hadn't worked with a particle system in Blender before, and it was pretty fun. And I in the end of the day, I figured out how to actually keep the weapon's momentum of the object and then translate that to the particle. So you see the one that flies off here? It actually keeps the momentum of the sword, so it doesn't just fly straight up. So yeah, that was a fun little project, and the Casper is so good at making props as well, so it was... I didn't really do anything with this, I just took his stuff and then fucked around with it, like I usually do with Casper's stuff, because he's my bitch and he does whatever I want! So yeah, I think we're done with the guy's body now. Let's just animate the face, and then we're done with this guy. And he doesn't talk, so that's great. I think he doesn't talk. Let's stop it.
I have bad legs. And
I have bad legs, but that's not the guy talking. That's the old woman talking. Shocker, huh? Who knew? I like to make them blink when going to another pose. It's easier to draw, and I'd say it's pretty realistic. Maybe I don't know this shit. Poor lady, yeah. However, when going to... Sometimes I don't even want to do a blink, so I won't. So yeah, that's my... workflow. Just shoot from the hip, baby. And remember, he goes down a little bit with his head there, so I need to follow with the face. That's just proper etiquette. But I want a blink here. Oh, Jesus Christ, that scared the living shit out of me. That's how it sounds when I get an email. Oh man, how embarrassing. No, it wasn't embarrassing. You should be upfront with your flinches, that's what I always say. Thank you. How do you change your email sound? I'm using Firebird and Firebird yeah, has some option where you can change the sound. It was a long time ago, but I think it was fairly easy. It just gets Firebird. Firebird's great if you have more than one email. Well, I guess it's great if you just have one as well, because it's you don't have to go into a website to look at your email. And that's great. Yeah, I changed my Skype sounds as well a long time ago. I really easily flinch as well. Like when someone just bikes by me when I listen to music, I usually flinch like a fucking idiot. And you just have to live with it. If you're a scaredy cat, just live with it. And here's a Wombat, folks. Real hype music for all the ladies and all the boys. I really want to have that guy on another stream. It was so much fun to talk to. You also feel like streaming, Glenn? I hope you guys don't mind that I'm not talking that much, because When you solo stream, sometimes you just doze off and listen to the music. But if you have any questions or whatever, you can just ask it. I'm glancing at the chat from now and then. I promise you. Yeah, I know what you mean, Glenn. I also tend to put most of my concentration on the actual animation and I can't really take off of topics or whatever. I mean, I could talk to you about the Minus Renta as much as I want to, but you don't give a shit. And this is life. By the way, me and Walter played some Kill Fania yesterday. And if you guys haven't checked it out, you really should. It's a game that Walter and a programmer named Johan Larsson worked on, and it's a 2D shooter goodness, multiplayer, and you can design your own skins and everything, and it's on Steam. It's really fun, and it's really too bad that there's not enough players, so sometimes the servers are empty, but I assure you that if you jump on a server and you stand there a little while, people will come. And I think the game really needs people like that to get it off the ground. But yeah, it's a really fun game. Kill Fun, yeah. We actually did a trailer, if you haven't seen it, on the Thunder Humor channel a long time ago. Bam! Animation done! Let's color that shit and then add a scarf! Let's just color everything brown. I don't think I've talked about it, but this animation is much more, how would you say it, scripted than our usual cartoons, because we actually wrote a script for this one, and it's gonna be interesting to see what people think, because it's a bit more coherent, I guess. I really love it, actually. I think it's one of our better ones, story-wise. So yeah, I hope you guys will like it so we can keep doing more stuff like this. The problem is that when you make stuff more coherent, it's obviously longer. Because you can't just go from stuff to stuff. There needs to be some kind of thread, I guess. But it's fun to write scripts, and I want to do it a bit more. Get better at it, because right now I'm really not good at it. But you gotta try. Keep at it. Maybe one day you'll become Mr. Big Man. But that's not something I want to be. I don't want to be a big man. I just want to be a little animator. That makes me happy. But yeah, I hope you guys will like it. I have too many scripts for animations, says Glenn as well. Yeah, it's easy to just... I know that some people really love to write scripts instead of animating, and then they just get a lot of scripts piled up. And I'm really not that kind of animator. I'm more like, okay, let's get a script done so I can start fucking animating, because that's what I want to do. Let's just add this G darn scarf. Raba bada rubu baru. When you make these small movements, the scarf is can be a bit hard to animate. Shit. I gotta zoom in, guys. It's inevitable. Ah, shit. One more frame and see how that looks. Maybe I need to add more. I'll probably have to add more. It's really hard to take the easy way out. And I'm not talking about suicide. Because you're not gonna get any animation done while you're dead. Yeah, one more maybe. Maybe two. Probably too, because you can never take the easy way out. I'm not sure if I told you that, but you can't. You gotta add two more frames when you think you can add one more frame. But goddamn, I'm gonna add one and then look at it and say, oh yeah, I did need to add two more frames. No, actually, one more frame, but that would be two more frames if I was talking before. So, yeah. One more in between for the ladies. Sometimes it's just easier to work without the anti-aliasing. Yeah, there we go! Scarf Heaven! Actually, no, that's weird. It's not supposed to go in that much. Fuck, man. Goes in way too much. Fuck. Such is life. You just gotta slowly learn how a scarf works. What if we do it like this? Would that be too easy? Yeah, that's more like it. But look at that. Yeah, there we go. Some subtle moves on this scarf that nobody probably will see, but I will enjoy doing so. Who gives a sheesh? It's the little things. But we want to have the old lady above the scarf. Ah, shit. I accidentally painted the outline. You don't want to do that, guys. That's more like it. Yeah, look at that. Sweet. Oh. Oh. I'm dropping shit on the floor again. My cleaner is gonna get mad at me. Good thing I don't have a cleaner. I need some water though. I'll be back in a minute. Oh, a second. Because I've got a tiny fucking apartment and I can talk with you guys. Even though I'm in my refrigerator right now. It's important to have water in the fridge so you can get liquefied. No, that's not the hydrated. Hydrated and liquefied is not the same thing, guys. That's the first thing you learn in school. Yep, I'm the new Terminator. Oh, where the fuck did I put my pen? The old lady looks like a sneaky snake. Yeah, she's kind of a sneaky snake. Look. This is my favorite part of this song. Are you guys ready? Here it comes. Crank it up! Haha! It's so so soothing. It's so floaty. Yeah, that's my jam. So how do we want the breakdown? The breakdown is what they call the frame where it all changes. She's gonna pick up her foot here, so maybe we can't get away with just one frame. Oh, we probably can. That's too bad. So she puts a lovely grip of her foot like this. Really, really. Yeah, with the oh, speaking about Breaking Bad, that was a while ago now. If there's something I really like about TV series, it's the title, like the intro animation. It's always so fun to look at. For example, the new Better Call Saul has like a new one for each episode, if I'm not mistaken. I really like that. That's gonna be fine. Too much onion skin. I can't see what the fuck I'm doing. One more frame, and I think that would be enough frames. Let's just take this head, because you don't want to redraw that head every time. Looks weird. That's better. I'm not sure if I want her to actually reach over with her other arm. I guess she doesn't need to. So let's just screw that. You know what's great about in-betweens? You don't look at them for more than a fraction of a second. Just a tiny bit of a second. Actually, 1/24th of a second. Or 1/12th, actually, because I hold it for 2 frames. But anyways, you can't really see that something looks like shit. So, just habit conviction. Yeah, that should be okay. So let's just make her hair follow the physics of today's reality. Scoobity ba ba ba, scoobity ba ba da. Worth a try. Ah, fuck it. This is good enough. Good enough. So, actually, any other plans for today? No, I don't think so. I wanna play some Hands of Fate, that's for sure. But, that's about it. I just wanted to have one shot done. That's really everything I planned for today. Oh, and I planned that I wanted a fucking pizza as well. So I'm gonna get a fucking pizza. Nobody can stop my pizza eating contest with myself. And you can take how much time you want. Just enjoy that pizza, and you'll win. Ba, 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 ba. This is one of my favorite songs by Polito. It's so good. Baby day. Hey Axel, I'm gonna do the same, says CJ and Moose. It was really hard to see on it looks great on the live stream. Because you don't have the same color on the live stream apparently. But yeah. You gonna eat a pizza or you gonna finish a shot? Or you gonna do both? Like a real fucking Axel. Thunderhumor stream. Sup, Lassifool. How are you doing today? This stuff goes down way too far. I'm gonna have to fix that. Ain't nobody gonna fix it for me. Ba ba doo. Skip it about ba doo ba doo. Skip ba doo. Fuck, man. Yeah, that's good enough.
How's the animation making creation going? It's going good!
During this stream we've gotten this guy all wrapped up and ready to go. So now we just got a little old lady picking up her own leg. And oh man, I wish I had a cat. It's just too much work. And I'm pretty sure cats don't like me, so that's gonna be a bit of a problem as well. But I really like cats. They're so not really cuddly, not when I'm close to them, but they look cuddly, and that's enough. That's enough for me, actually. Maybe it's just the cat my parents have. That just doesn't like cuddly. You really gotta smooth talk her first before getting any kind of action. And I'm talking like hours of smooth talking. concerned man, yeah man. And he's animated as well. Not all concerned men are that, so I'd say that's a win in my book. Cats are strongly independent, yeah. I guess that's the problem. We should just try to wither them down through generation and generation and get a docile pet in return. I'm just kidding. I think that's fine. One more frame and that should be enough. Yeah, yesterday I watched the first season of the Eric Andre show. Have you guys seen that? It's very Tim and Eric-y, but a bit more, even more hectic and all over the place. I really liked some part of it. You can see that Adult Swim. I think it's up to 3 seasons right now.
It's so gray today! Why is it so gray? It's making me all tired. Look at this, folks. Look how gray it is. Wait, maybe you can see it. Wait. I'm a cameraman. I'm a good fucking cameraman. Oh shit! I'm not a good cameraman. I just broke it. Fucking shit, man. Am I supposed to crawl under my desk now to fix it? Alright, I'll crawl for you guys. Fucking hell. I'm not getting paid to crawl. Let's see if that works. Yeah, bro. Okay, cool. Rainy day. Picking up your foot animation. Great tutorial if you guys wanna try this out at home, which I bet most of you do if you're not fucking weirdos. Okay, so let's start with making her actually look at the guy. Thank you.
think I need to listen to the audio now. Probably.
I have bad legs.
I have. Okay, so she needs to have more of a sad eyebrows, asking for help kind of eyebrows. And I had. And she's gonna. She's gonna take a little bit of blink, a little blink. When going down, because this lady, she does no scope picking up of legs, and that's kind of amazing. I don't
bad,
think.
Bad.
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 Bad legs, and then she should probably have even bigger eyes, because she really wants the guy to help her, and. Is there a better way to get someone to help you than to have big eyes? I don't think so, bro. A little bit. That. So now we have the correct position and we can just push the eyebrows down a little bit. Make the eyes bigger. You really gotta do these things right, guys. You can't just animate an old woman's eyes just willy-nilly. Nah, man. Pupils a little bit bigger as well. Yeah, I should do the trick. Maybe. Yeah. So let's just flip those. And perfect. Wait a second, guys. We can't have a look like that. Do you really think? Too much. Maybe I want to keep the pupil length. That's a sentence I say pretty much daily.
Bad legs.
I like this one. I didn't like the other one. So let's just do it like this. Ha! Cheating!
I have bad legs. Bad legs.
Is this good enough? Oh look, it's Homer Simpson! No, it's not. Okay, let's go with that. That's fine. My keyboard is really starting to decay! Fucking hell, man. This is me. There we go.
Bad leg. Bad leg. I have bad leg. I have bad legs. Bad legs. A bad leg.
Yeah, that's good. Let's go with that. I have bad legs. I have bad legs. I have bad legs. And, did you guys hear who the voice actress is? It's a first timer. Super bad legs, bruh. One more frame and the eyes are done. Forever done. What an amazing feeling. Okay, mouth time. And I need to turn off the music, I'm afraid. So this lady have one less teeth than a normal old lady. That's what's making her more important than other. So first I start with just making the basic mouth movements, and then I add in betweens later. Kinda like I did the body, I guess. Sometimes I just go straight ahead, but you can miss some important stuff then, so. I wonder if I should just make No, I should make it like this. Yeah. I have... Come along, guys, try this at home! The big bad wolf, but one less tooth. Oh shit, I just forgot one important little line. The most important line in any mouth is the beneath the mouth line. It's important because what? No, it's not.
I have that. I have that.
I have bad legs. And I don't give a shit. Come on, everybody, move your legs. Forgot the old lines. How embarrassing! How embarrassing!
I have bad legs, and I have bad legs, and I
have bad legs, and I. What's gonna happen next, guys? You'll never know.
Bad legs, and bad legs, and I have bad legs. I have bad legs, and I have bad legs.
Yeah. Now we can crank up the music again. And let's just do some in the fucking tweens. I'm not sure if I'm gonna draw the background now as well. Well, maybe I'll do that just to have finished one shot from start to end on the stream. Well, I haven't really, but...
I have that.
Yeah, I guess when you solo stream, there's not as many people actually showing up. That's fine. I just wanted to do some streaming today.
I have that.
But that's fine. I kind of wanted this stream to be more of a laid back, cozy stream. People can just have it going on in the background or whatever. Have you started streaming yet, Clem? Or Sven? No, I haven't, Sklen. I'd rather finish you strong and watch your stream until you stop. Sounds like a plan, Mr. Man. Forward to the Gotham episode now that you gave me that little info. I really like Gotham. It's a great show!
I have bad legs!
One more frame and the mouth is done. How about them apples? Have you ever seen an old woman's mouth being fully animated in one stream? I think you haven't. I don't think you have. And I think I've just broke that world record. And I'll accept the prize anytime.
Bam! I have bad legs, and I have bad legs.
Bam! Okay, so let's... let's call it this, and... I think I'll do the background... or maybe not, man. I don't know, what's the clock for? No. I'll wrap up the stream after I've called this, and you'll have to wait for the video to watch the background, because that's what you want. Look at this, look at this in between, man. I'm not sure if I can live with this. That's a bit more acceptable. I haven't even imported this latest color palette. Wow. Granny! There we go, that's her actual skin color. It's important to have the right skin color for your granny. A little tip to you aspiring animators out there. She has cotton candy hair, this old lady. Because that's how I like my old ladies. Thanks for calling Guinness, my man. Ask for a beer while you're at it. Wow, funny jokes. Yeah, you can be both my manager and my agent. And my hitman. You can be everything, bruh. Did it! I hope you, some of you enjoyed
hanging out with me today. This rather quiet solo stream. Thanks to you guys that tagged along. It's been like 5 of you throughout. So yeah, catch you guys next time. Bye.